Hi everyone, this is Chetan. I will be working on scaling 30 TB of data lake with Apache HBase and Scala DSL production. What is Scala? Scala is function programming language. It supports the object-oriented paradigm and strongly typed inference. You can use the higher order function and lazy computation engine. So we talk about the real use case about detailed analytics. So this case study we worked for our customer in Pittsburgh. Their business owner talks about how their customers are doing detailing, what they are doing, when they are doing, how it's happening, everything. So they get in terms of data in POS files, and the files need to be processed, and you get the data. So the volume of data was 4.7 billion requests per day, and in terms of volume, it was 30 GB of data per day. So we talk about what is selling as compared to what was being ordered. fit to promotion that you can apply, right promotion at right outlet and right time. What type of products are selling, like if they are selling cigarette, consumers are shopping at some outlet. If they want to get use the smoking patterns in specific geography and predict the demand on supply, what are the purchasing patterns of the consumer? Are they purchasing pizza with ice cream? Are they purchasing multiple instant food products with the soda together? And times this problem, like how patterns happening in the sales and demand. So this is the case study, some of the use cases that I'm talking about. So we built the, this case study is on about entire data processing platform and how HBase plays a role and just make the game changing performance here. So challenges are weekly data refresh, daily data refresh, and the Spark job, Hadoop jobs, execution failure with the unutilized Spark cluster. Scalability of data was 4.6 billion events on every data refresh, and processing historical data also with 100 GB of data with 17 billion transaction records. Execution was kind of sequential, that was blocking the pipeline of the data and without unidentified exceptions. Joining skewed data nature for 17 billion transactional data deduplication. For example, I'm talking about two KPI out in an item. So when they get the data in terms of outlet data and item data, figuring out it is, whether it's duplicated or not, that was cumbersome. So I'll give some simple example that when HBase plays a role for the data duplication algorithms. For example, when we want to do matching on the outlet, item, brand, and address matching, abbreviation standardization was playing the role to make the data problematic, like unit of measure pack quantity 2, same thing 2 pack, values NA, here 2 PK, values nothing there. So this kind of one of the problem statement, and standardize the UIM, outlet name, address, and the UPC. Data deduplication problem in the detail, how it causes issues, like you may find item with same UPC code, you may find outlet with same outlet number. What if the UPC code get upgraded from 10 digit to 14 digit? Update everywhere, just need the faster update on that. So HBase provides the faster update. If you load all the data from the Kafka to Spark Streaming to, for example, Hive, we can only do the insert. We cannot do update. We cannot remove the value from the Hive because ETL will be extract, transform, and load. When we need it for the MDA kind of problem to match the data with item and outlet, at that time we need to do update. So this is kind of sort of example that how HBase helped in this platform. For example, if you have a table called transactional line item with the column family F, O, and T, F files or outlet and T with transaction, all the column of the column family has column like data, date time, file, transactional ID. So it will become the automatically denormalized schema. So it saves the couple of joins that you do on the 17 billion transactions. And the outlet information will be outlet column family, like outlet ID, name, state, city, and everything. Transaction will have the outlet ID, transaction ID here. So you can do group by all of that, kind of those operations. Yeah, so question would be how it was possible this scaling data-like problem statement. So we'll talk about the high-level architecture first. That source of data was RDBMS legacy Oracle from that and the POS files. So Kafka is queuing and passing the files and supplying Kafka topic top of the Spark Streaming. And Spark Streaming ingest data to the HBase tables S equal to Kafka topics here. And Those data will get snapshot to NTFS and high yield Spark and Presto will do real time querying on top of the HBase. Well, when I talk about Spark, the Scala program and Spark was written to fetch data in terms of real time and scheduled frequently using the controller tool. And we do the, on top of that, we apply the Spark ML and scikit-learn ML models, which do training on NTFS but apply the inference on Spark streaming. So we those data was not required, those not got ingested to the HBase. And to apply the portal on top of the, the interface for the customer to figuring out whether the recommendation provided by the Spark MLLib algorithm is true or not. So the support team will access the portal, which has the data, and those data exposed in the APCA HTTP library, and we were using the async library because HBase was 0.98 version. And I know that in HBase 2.0 there is a by default built-in sync library, and also Node.js was there to get API exposed on top of the portal. To move data from HBase to sync with the Elasticsearch, we were using the Mapper CLI index cron job, which applied the syncing data from HBase table to index on Elasticsearch. And the sync library plays role to get the data from the Spark streaming here and just match with the Elasticsearch index. If item is get meshed, then update to the by default to HBase table. So those operations write or update what happening with the sync library with the Akka and Scala here. This exposing API, we use with Node.js to expose API here. The way data ingestion happened for one of the other platform was in here to HBase, it executed with the Spark job, get data into high staging layer as it is. And since Hive is used here as an analytical engine, so there is one more snapshot of the Hive which created the aggregated job layer here. The asynchronous HBase we used is available here, and the command to get sync the data from HBase table to Elasticsearch index are here. Okay. So I'll explain you the build.sbt that we use for this project to get this mentioned. So these are these couple of libraries we have used to provide asynchronous non-blocking Elastic performance platform. So we use the Akka Actor, Akka MDB core library, Akka Spring to get a JSON so it get indexed with Elasticsearch, Kafka Client Spray, and this library that I'm talking about. Sync HBase 1.02. In terms of versioning of the platform, for the data lake, it's Apache HBase 0.98.12 because of the distribution we were using for our customer was Mapper distribution ecosystem 5.x CentOS. And the Spark for data processing and NTFS for processing data, Kafka for queuing system and streaming, HTTP Akka, Scala, and Spark streaming, Postgre for analytical purpose, and Oracle line for source of data. For scheduling workflow, we are using the BMC program. So this is all about how to create fast data processing platform. We need to unify and simplify architecture rather than going with the too many technologies like earlier. We were trying to do join with HBase table with Hive table by using the drill, but it was failing because of so much of data. So when we talk about scale of data, we need data lake. To get the reliability and performance, we need data warehouse like Hive. And for low latency, we need streaming like Kafka streaming or Spark streaming. And the Spark HBase connector we have used to provide this performance was not Spark HBase connector. So this is, I mean, when we started this, it was around 1.5 years ago. At that time, I don't think HBase context was working in Spark HBase. Plus, there was one more connector by Hortonworks, Spark on HBase, which was also failing with the network and so many other issues. So simplest way for us was to use this package by Nandanarmak, but it was failing for Spark 2. It was working for Spark, so it's Scala 2.10, but it was not working for Scala 2.11 because of the limitation of the tuple in Scala 2.10-12. So we cannot read the we can read the column family at 12 and the number of columns 12. So I did contribution in this project, this connector, and it supports now 2.11 and Scala 2.12. We are working on Scala 3 with the Goti compiler. So this Spark HBase connector is written in on top of the Java HBase API itself, a simple, elegant way to write Spark and HBase jobs, and powerful functions DSL integrated for Spark. It supports the CATS library, it supports the Scala Z library. Those are the category theory way to apply the functional way of Scala on top of that. So it supports the Scala 2.10 above, and Spark 1.6 above, and HBase 1.4 above. So when you apply dependency on top of the Spark jobs, you need to provide dependency build.spd in this way. The package name and version and everything. You need to do either configuration by going to the HBase site.xml, provide this forum, or you can apply here on configuration Spark submit. Yeah, so this is a way in this library. If you want to write back to HBase, so in this example, we are getting the RDB of the tuple. So first will be row key and second will be column names value here. So if you want to, this is RDB HBase that is parallelized and created of the number 1 to 10, so 1 to 100. And RDB HBase, if you want to write back, you want to say 2 HBase table name and 2 column names, column 1 and column 2. So if you can see here, there's 3 values here in this tuple, right? So this value will be column 1, hello will be in column 2, and but the first value will be row key. So there's no need to pass the value in when you do 2 columns here. And then you have to say in column family, column name, and cell. If you want to read data from the HBase, Spark context dot HBase table, and you have to provide the argument here. By default, first value will be string to get the row key, and integer and string the way you want to get populated data here, and column family, and you have to say a link here. So for example here now, if you want to read only those columns that are not part of the column family, you can provide the prefix. So here the in column family provides the column family number 1, then you don't have to provide prefix here. But if you want to read the columns of different column family, then you have to provide the column family prefix here. HBase connector provides the filtering. You can apply the start and stop row scan filtering here, since HBase is a fast scan feature. So you can provide start row and stop row here by the row key here, so you can get all those parts that you are looking for data. And this can save the shuffle that happen on top of the cluster. So it made possible when you get data, you get null pointer exception kind of issues in the in this way. So you can use this Scala way of option. So option is kind of algebraic type. You are trying that you are saying that either get the value of string or get value none. So it won't show the exception. When we want to just map the any structure of the data with the data frame or the RDD, you will use the case class where you when you populate the kind of way you do in Java like POJO or the structure. These are the examples that I'm saying student case class and semester subject and exam result. So when you want to read the customized way, you need to use the file reader of the student. Student is the case class, the way you want data, and then you can get data from bytes to the primitive type of data here. You need to override the implicit method column here and provide sequence of the, all the columns that you are trying to read or write. Yeah, so this was an example to do field mapping and do read and write. So when you want to do read, you have to use the HBase table and the class name here and say to in column family and map it. Map is the higher order function in Scala or any function programming language that that gives you all the value, and then you just map with the that all the attributes of the case class, and then 2DS will create the strongly typed data set object, same for others. When you want to write back, you need to use the file writer class and provide the structure of the table that you're trying to write. Make sure that when you provide the sequence here in the map, exam result will be the case class name, and two, the type of the return value for the map will be HBase data, and provide all the sequence. If you provide the sequence, so it can automatically pass to the data frame here. So if you see here, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 columns, but the argument and sequence are 9. Because you need to provide one more as a row key here. So, for example, if you want to make the row key of column 1 plus 2 plus 3 of the hash, you can provide that value here. So, you can identify those rows uniquely and by computing the same thing when you want to again do item matching, output matching kind of way. This example says when you want to save the data, you can predefine the type by providing any Scala type way like a string and integer and the value that you get from the RDD and write back to the HBase table in Spark way. So these are the reference, all the packages that we were used. A character with library with version and the Node.js script2, Node.js async, and there will be one more Node.js. I think I forgot one reference that is a Node.js HBase client that is required to do connection over there. So, just going towards the case study. Again back. This case study, I'm in the HBase where the role to get out of data deduplication issues to match the 70 billion item and objects. So this use case was a kind of MDM system as HBase. And it saves around 22 hours of the runtime for the customer. And this platform is not used by only one customer. The platform can be used for the customer since it provides the kind of forum family way doing the approach. Yes, that's all. Any questions?
Right, ma'am.